I hope everyone completed first, second application. If you are getting 404 error means problem. I'll tell today you will get to know. Don't install Tomcat in C drive. Always make sure that Tomcat is there other than C drive. Those who completed, good. So now today we will give second application is not uploaded to FBR. Mr. Pradap, you are not properly observing things, guys. Yesterday's application is not. See, this one is there now, boss. Class content, advanced Java 114, servlet. I think I have uploaded yesterday. Maybe date, for 3 dates, same thing. Uploaded, boss, uploaded, uploaded. All 3 days content is there in the same file. Both days content is there in the same file. Please, guys. Yes. Class content, advanced Java 114 servlet. Okay. Servlet based web application development, John 29th. Servlet based web application development, John 29th. Okay. Servlet based web application development, John 29th, guys. Okay. So, shall we observe that one, boss? Sir, you most of the people might have got 404 error. Yes, na? Okay. So, now let me give the reasons why this 404 error will come. 404 error will come for the following reasons. Will come for the following reasons. The 404 error will come for the following reasons. Yes. Number one, eDrive, Tomcat 9.x, bin directory, Tomcat 9.exe file. First of all, let me confirm our application is running smoothly. Our application running smoothly, guys. Come here. http://localhost2525.datapp/first. datapp/first. We got the output or not? Okay. So now I'll disturb the deployment directory structure a little bit. datapp instead of web hyphen, I'm taking web underscore. Instead of web hyphen, I'm taking web underscore. All right. Now you observe. Localhost 2525/datapp first. 404 error has come now, guys. Okay. Number one, for wrong deployment directory structure. For wrong deployment directory structure. yesterday notes also uploaded. On one file, two dates are given. Sometime when continuation is there, one file will be having two dates. Please read the, don't be hurry, boss. For one file, two dates will be there. For wrong directory structure, for wrong deployment directory structure. For wrong deployment directory structure. Yes, guys. Next one. Anyone? Wrong names. Wrong names for standard. Wrong names for standard directory names. Standard directory names. Or wrong hierarchy. Wrong hierarchy folders and etc. Okay. Fine, boss. Everyone observe, max to max you will get 400 error, 404 error, 500 error. For both I am going to give solution. Okay, for wrong URL, for wrong URL typed in the browser address bar. For wrong URL typed in the browser address bar. Yes, first URL enter key. 404 error. Here is my first. Okay. 2525 date app. What is there first, guys? Date app. What is there? What first? Wrong URL. If you enter, okay, I correct previous mistake first. F3 here, web-inf, okay. So, all right, web-inf output came. But I have given wrong URL, f.c 404. Wrong web application name, 404. Any problem in the browser address bar, you will get 404 error. See, guys. Okay, let us assume I did mistakes in web.xml file. Suppose I have not closed URL pattern tag. I have not closed URL pattern tag. Let us assume I have not closed. Already error has come, but when error is there, if you give request, you will get 404 error. See, correct URL only. Right now I'm not giving wrong URL. I'm doing perfect URL only, 404 error. Now you solve the problem. Save it. Give time to server console to reload. Yes, reloaded. Say refresh. Okay, give time. Yes. Give time. So that means if you write wrong entries in web.xml file, wrong entries in web.xml file, you will get this. For the wrong entries, place it in web.xml file. Okay, for the wrong entries, place it in web.xml file. Okay, that means basic XML syntax. Basic XML syntactical mistakes. Basic XML syntactical mistakes. That's it. That is C, guys. Next, D. For the wrong entries, place it in web.xml file. Basic XML syntactical mistakes, guys. Sir, at what time you will get 404 error, guys? Okay. suppose syntactically right, okay, logical name and logical name not matching. Logical name in servlet tag, logical name is not matching here. Come on, guys. Not matching. Look at this. Completed. It's giving error. Okay, but still I am giving request. 404. Again, we are getting problem or not there. Okay. If the servlet configuration logical name is not matching with servlet mapping logical name. Servlet configuration logical name is not matching with the servlet mapping logical name. That time also you will get 404 error. That time also you will get 4. I'm trying to put different permutation and combinations to get this what 404 error. Okay, guys. Next, I changed web.xml file name to web1.xml. Web.xml file name to web1.xml. Again, we are getting 4. Say refresh. Even the web.xml file name is changed, it is not a reader. Oh, nothing is there. Okay, we have both web and web.xml. That's why. Okay, now have a look now. Okay, say refresh 404. Have a look now. We are having 404. Understanding my statement, guys? Yes, okay. If web.xml file name is changed to other file name. If web.xml file name is changed to other file name. So like this, there will be a number of reasons to get this 404 error. Convinced with me, guys? Okay, guys. Now tell me, anyone has got 500 error, guys? Anyone has got 500 error? Let me know. No one has got 500 error? If web.xml is not there, then also you'll get 404 error. Okay, guys. Now listen. When 500 error will come? Reason number one. Will come for the following reasons. 500 error will come for the following reasons. Yeah, listen. Wrong class name. This class is not there, guys. Wrong servlet class name. Maybe package name wrong. Okay, class name is wrong. Having this name, no class is there in our web application. Okay, now on safe side. On safe side, I'll restart the server freshly. Say refresh. 500 error is there. What is the error? Class not found. Find com.nt. Date servlet one. It is trying to load a date servlet one, not the date servlet. In our web application, we have date servlet. We don't have date servlet one. Come on, guys. So that's the reason there's a possibility of getting 500 error. Okay. Number A. If you place CBUS, if you are not able to access requested resource 404 error. Towards instantiation and initialization of servlet, if any problems are raised, okay. Instantiation means object creation. Initialization means assigning some initial values to the object. Towards instantiation and initialization of servlet class object, if any problems are raised, you will get 500 error. Okay. If we specify wrong class name, our package name in servlet-class tag of servlet tag in web.xml file. If we specify wrong class name or package name in servlet-class tag of servlet tag in web.xml file, what guys is in web.xml file? That's it, guys. What is the another story, boss? What is this? Class not found exception, com.nt.servlet.dateservlet1. That's the one thing. Next one. Let's see. Let's have a look on this. I'm going to classes folder. Now I'm deleting this web one. Okay. I'm going to classes folder. Open dateservlet.java. I have not taken servlet class as the public class. When you have not taken servlet class as the public class, CMD. Java C date servlet dot Java. Here is my compilation, guys. Compilation successful. But if it is not a public class, do you think it is visible to servlet container? No. But I'm giving request to that servlet component. Everything is perfect. Oh, 404 error. No, yeah. I'm looking for 500. Wait. I have to reload the web application. You know that. Whenever modification is done, we have to go for what? Reloading. Okay. http://. Here is what? Localhost 2525. Localhost 2525. Manager app. Admin. Admin 1. Admin 1. Oh, it's not cut data. Admin 1, okay, update the password. Date app say reloaded. After reloading, you give the request. 500 error. What is the 500 error? Class not found exception, date servlet 1. Sir, I'm feeling error has come because of entries gone wrong in web.xml file. Okay, now I corrected it. Okay, now I corrected it. Changes might be recognized. And now you observe. See, now this time, no. Error instantiating servlet class, date servlet. You configure date servlet, that class is not having public class. When it is not there having public modifier, it is not visible outside the package. Come on. It is not visible outside the package. Are you understanding my statement, guys? Come on. Yes. So this is what we need to focus. If you specify wrong class name or package name in servlet-class tag of this one. If the servlet component class name is not taken as public. If the servlet component class name is not taken as public class. Okay, public class. Next one. if servlet component class is not having zero param constructor directly or indirectly. Directly means placed by the programmer manually. Indirectly means generated by the Java compiler. As a default constructor. Yeah. Directly or indirectly, there is no what is that? Zero param constructor. If servlet component is not having, zero param constructor, public zero param constructor, directly or indirectly. Super guys. Now, how sir? Right now, don't worry about the constructor. If no constructors are placed, Java compiler automatically gives one default zero param constructor. You know that, right? Compilation is done. Check it out. Java p com dot nt dot servlet dot date servlet. See this, guys. I didn't place any constructor, but I got one default constructor. Did you notice it, guys? Did I place any constructor here? No. This constructor is given by whom? Java compiler. Who? This constructor is given by whom? Java compiler, Java C. Not the servlet container. Java compiler. That's the nature of Java compiler. Giving zero param constructor if no other constructors are placed in the Java class. So that is what? Public class date servlet. Okay, guys. Now I will place zero param constructor explicitly. Public date servlet. Tell me, system dot out dot println date servlet colon zero param constructor. Compile, guys. Now we have to reload the web application once. You keep separate tab for this reloading activity. Okay, reloaded. Say refresh. Output is coming. See the server console. Zero param constructor executed. You say refresh. Then also zero param constructor executes only for one time. Come on, my dears. Then also this zero param constructor executes only for one time. Are you getting my point here, guys? Come on. Are you understanding my statement here, guys? Right. Only one time, nah? I already said. Container creates only one object for our servlet component class, uses that object for multiple requests. Servlet component is single instance, multiple threads component. Forgot that point, huh? Okay. But service method will be called one time or multiple times, huh? Multiple times. Okay. Let's see. System.out.println. Date servlet service method. Date servlet, what is that service method? Cool. Manager, date app, reload. Refresh. What is this? Refresh, refresh. Listen, service method executed multiple time, but object is created only for one time or not? Object is created only for one time or not? If directly or indirectly zero param public constructor not there, you will get 500 error. Always remember, if any problems are there, to locate web component to map request to web component 404. If any problems are there towards what? Loading and instantiating servlet class, you will get 500 error. You will get 500 error. Problems related to servlet instantiation, 500 error. Problems related to mapping request to servlet component, 404 error. What error, guys? 404 error. If servlet component class is not having public zero param constructor directly, placed by programmer manually, indirectly generated by Java compiler as default constructor. Everyone understood my point here, guys? Come on, next, D. Okay, one more thing, guys. Constructor is there, but somehow it is there as a private constructor. Constructor is there, but that is having private constructor. Do you think private constructor is visible outside the class? No. But compilation successful. Reloading also happens successfully. Always keep one tab ready for this one, manager. Okay, say refresh. Again, 500 error. No such method. It is not able to find out constructor. Error instantiating servlet class. Did you notice that, guys? If he plays, okay, zero param constructor as, if you play zero param constructor as private constructor, private constructor in servlet component class, in servlet component class. Okay. Vinay Kumar, private constructor is visible outside the class? No. Without accessing constructor of the class, can anyone create object of that class, guys? No. Core Java, boss. Core Java. You're asking explanation for this point means you're very weak in Core Java to say straight away on your face. Okay, who creates our servlet class object? Servlet container. Come on. Okay, using which constructor? Zero param constructor. So that means, so for zero param constructor should be visible to container, servlet container. Visible or not visible? So then you will get what? 500 error. Saying that some problems related to instantiation and initialization. Simply saying there are some problems related to instantiation and initialization. There are some issues related to instantiation and initialization. Everyone got the clarity or not? Come on. If you place zero param constructor as private constructor in servlet component class. Okay. And etc. So one thing is clear. If servlet container fails to locate or map web component, locate or map web component for the given request to URL, then we get, so then we get 404 error. If servlet container if servlet container fails to load or instantiate fails to load or instantiate our servlet component class, then we get we simply get 500 error, guys. Okay, then we simply get 500 errors. Okay, some observations, guys. Okay, see, when you take a normal Java class, you can create object of that class by using 0 param, 1 param, 2 param, 3 param. Okay, your choice, because you are creating object here. Who is creating object? Servlet container. Using which constructor? 0 param constructor. So placing 0 param constructor in our servlet component class, directly or indirectly, is the responsibility of the programmer. Directly or indirectly is the responsibility of the programmer. Are you understanding my statement, guys? So servlet container creates our servlet component class object using 0 param constructor. So we must place 0 param constructor directly or indirectly in our servlet component class. Directly or indirectly in our servlet component class. That's the one thing. Note. So we must place using public 0 param constructor here also. By default, public only, we think that. Okay, guys. Next. If Java class is not having any constructor, then the Java compiler generates 0 param constructor. The Java compiler generates 0 param constructor as a default constructor. Generates public 0 param constructor as default constructor. See, boss, don't call every 0 param constructor as default constructor. The one that comes automatically through compiler when no constructors are placed is called 0 param constructor. Suppose you have manually placed 0 param constructor explicitly in .java file. You have explicitly placed 0 param constructor explicitly, boss. Let us assume you have explicitly placed 0 param constructor. Come on, guys. You have explicitly placed what? 0 param constructor. Then tell me what happens. You have explicitly placed 0 param constructor. You have explicitly placed what? 0 param constructor. Are you understanding my statement, guys? So then what happens? So that is not called default constructor. That should be called as 0 param constructor only. Only compiler generated public 0 param constructor is called default constructor. If such constructor is explicitly based by programmer, that should not be called as default. What's the meaning of default, guys? If nothing is there, the one that comes automatically is called default. Int A, no value is kept, default value is 0. That's fine. Int A is equal to 0. Tell me here, in int A is equal to 0, in int A is equal to 0, 0 is called default value or initial value? There 0 is called as what? Default value or initial value? speak out my dear, initial value, not the default value. Okay, all right. Only the Java compiler, Java C generated zero param constructor should be called as default constructor generated public zero param constructor. The programmer placed public zero param constructor will not commander default constructor. Yes, yeah, we have to supply everything according to container, guys, because container is executing our web component. Container is dealing with our what? Web component execution, servlet component execution. That's why. Okay, now you observe, guys, in our servlet program we kept pw.println. yes, we also kept sop statements. pw.println statement, pw.println message is go to browser as response content through response object web server web container. Understanding my statement, guys? But the message is kept by using SOP. They will be displayed on the server console as confirmation or log messages. Simply as the confirmation or log messages. The message is kept in. Yeah, today we don't learn, do the develop. We'll observe first application very thoroughly, boss. The message is kept in pw.println statements. Go to browser as response content or web page content. Through response object, next what is this? Web container, next web server. Response object, web container, web server. Okay, next one. The message is kept in system.out.println statements. Go to server console. As log or confirmation messages. As log or confirmation messages. Are a server console, guys. Whenever you start the server, one console window is coming, not that console window. Now I am asking one question. Can I place only parameterized constructor in our servlet component class? I want reply from everyone. Only two people have responded. Can I place only parameterized constructor in our servlet component? Respond, guys. Respond, guys. No. Why, sir? Why, sir? If I place any user-defined constructor, default constructors will not come. Yes, you know that. If I place any user-defined constructor, then default constructor will not come. Point number one. Point number two. Okay. So, servlet container creates our servlet component class object by using which constructor here? Zero param constructor. Are you ready with the zero param constructor now? No. Because compiler is not generating and explicitly we are not adding, we are dealing with parameterized constructor. Possible or not possible? Not possible. Possible or not possible? Definitely not possible. Understanding my statement? Okay. Answer, no. Sir, core Java boss, core Java boss. Vinay Kumar, you have to sit in core Java class once. Whenever I talk core Java, you are asking me repeat again. I think you have to improve your core Java fundamentals once. I hope you studied all these things in your core Java or not. Come on, guys, tell me. When no constructors are there, then only Java compiler generate default constructor. If I place any user-defined constructor, maybe zero param, maybe one param, maybe three param, then default constructor, which is nothing but zero param constructor, will not be created. Will not be generated. But servlet container always looks to create our servlet class object through zero param constructor. Agree with me? So, but here in our servlet class, zero param constructor is available. If I place only parameterized constructor, no, not possible. So that's the reason there is a possibility of getting what? Okay, 500 error again, 500 error again. If you place public constructor, but you have placed it as what? Only parameterized constructor. Check it out. So public constructor only I have taken, guys. I have taken public. Public, yeah, here what? Into X, into Y. Into X, into Y. But container looks to create object by using zero param. Reload, source code modification now. Reload. Reload, refresh, refresh. Again, we are getting 500 error. Sir, how can you say error is because of that only? You comment this. Into X comma into Y. Nice. Here is my recompile. Here is my reload. Now it's coming. Now it's coming. Lot of core Java, guys. No. I hope you got a lot of confirmations, guys. Small, small improvisations, but we got a lot of confirmations here. Did you notice it? But one more thing you observe, the modifications done in HTML file, web.xml is reflecting immediately. Whereas the modifications done in what? Other web components of web application will not be reflecting immediately. There's just bit process that we have to follow. Understanding my statement, guys. The modification done in HTML files, in fact, non-Java resources, and web.xml will be recognized automatically by server, because for every change done in deployment directory structure of the web application, so the server continuously automatically reloads the web application. I hope you are understanding my point there. Okay. Shahil Khan, I'm able to see your message, guys. See this. Today I'm going to modify URL pattern. First one I have written. I'm not reloading. Check it out. I changed first one, give some time to recognize the changes internally. It is automatically reloaded also, guys. It is automatically reloading. We need not reload. Now first is old one. First one is the new one. Am I doing reloading of web application? No. Okay. The modifications done in web.xml file, the deployment directory structure of the file, public area web components. Will be recognized by the web application automatically. What do you say, guys? Come on. Are you with me? Okay. Web application automatically. Because for all these changes, the servlet container automatically reloads the web application. Okay. Whereas the modifications done in servlet component will reflect only after recompilation of servlet component and reloading of the web application. I hope you notice it, guys. Just now I have changed URL pattern web first to first one. Did I do any reloading explicitly? No. But if I do modification in the source code of this Arlet, definitely recompilation and reloading is required. As on today, this is the problem. You do any change to deployment directory structure, yes, it will reflect. You do any change in HTML, it will be taken dynamically. You do any changes, okay, in WebINF folder or classes folder or somewhere else, you will get 500 error. Understanding my statement, guys? Okay, now can I ask one question? Who is creating request comma response objects? Yourself or Arlet container? Arlet container. Okay, boss. How does it will be created? For all requests together, one request and response object, or for every request, separate request and response objects? Yes. Arlet container creates one set of request comma response objects for every request. And these objects will be destroyed once request related response came back to the browser. Very temporarily, Arlet container creates request comma response objects for every request, guys, every request. Once request related response is displayed on the browser, all those objects will be destroyed. Okay, guys, now listen. I have given 20 requests to Arlet component. Tell me how many sets of request comma response objects will be created? One set or 20 sets? 20. Okay. 20 sets of request comma response object. What is the lifetime of these objects? They will be there forever, or at the end of response generation, they will be destroyed. At the end of response generation, they will be destroyed automatically. Okay, now tell me, how many objects for our Arlet component class will be created? Only one object. You give any number of requests, you do anything, but Arlet container basic theory is only one object for our Arlet component class will be created. Sir, I don't want to listen this one theoretically, I want to feel it practically. What is that? Okay, boss. If we give 10 requests to our Arlet component, the Arlet container creates ten sets of request comma response objects. 10 sets of request comma response objects for 10 requests. Request comma response objects. Note, these request comma response objects will be destroyed. Will be destroyed automatically. At the end of request related response generation. These request comma response objects will be destroyed automatically at the end of request related response generation. Okay. If you give 10 requests to this one, now tell me here. Okay, 10 sets of request comma response objects representing 10 requests. Copy. Next. Next one. Next one. Come on. 10 sets of request, comma, response objects representing 10 requests, guys. Tell me. 10 threads representing 10 requests. How many threads will be created, guys? 10 threads representing 10 requests. That is B. Tell me. How many objects of? If we give 10 requests to our servlet component. How many objects of our servlet component class will be created? Only one object will be created for our servlet component class, main class. Only one object will be created for our servlet component class. Yes, guys. These are the three basic things you have to observe. If I depict this one in the form of diagram, right? You feel this is our web server. You feel this is servlet container. This is our web application. This is my web application. This is web server. This is servlet container. Catalina. They have given nickname for servlet container in this version. That is what? Catalina. Okay. Now tell me, guys. Only one object of our servlet component class. Only one object of our servlet component class, guys. Right. Suppose I have given three requests. First, what will be created? Demon process will be created. This is what process, guys? Demon process. Demon process. Tell me here. How many requests, guys? Three requests. Here is my thread one. Okay, guys. Now tell me here. This is request one. Request one. Created thread one. Created thread two. Created thread three. Okay. Delegating the request to whom? Servlet component. Yes, guys. But how many sets of request, comma, response objects will be created by container? One set. Here is my request. Here is my response. Okay. three requests. Request one, request two, next request three. How many threads are created? Three threads. Every thread is about to execute our web component. Come on. About to execute our web component. So here, what is this? Request object. Response. Request object. Here what? Response object. Again, request object. Again, response object. Yes. I hope you got a clarity here. Come on. If I give 100 requests to servlet component, come on, tell me. Servlet container creates what? Only one object for our servlet component class. Agree with me? How many objects? Only one object for our servlet component class. Come on, guys. Right. How many threads will be created representing multiple requests, multiple threads? How many request and response objects will be created for multiple requests? Multiple sets of request comma response object. Once a response delivered back to browser, they will be destroyed. So will they allocate memory forever? No. So they will, they are temporary. Suppose if request processing taking 1 second time, within 1 second, those objects will be destroyed. If request processing is taking 20 seconds, within 20 seconds only, those objects will be destroyed. Are you understanding my point there? Who will destroy the object? I already said servlet container maintains its own garbage collector to destroy the objects. Servlet container maintains its own garbage collector to destroy the objects. Did you remember that? Are you understanding my statement? Okay. Servlet container uses its own algorithm or garbage collector to destroy our servlet class objects. To destroy our servlet class objects and other objects. To destroy our servlet class object and other objects. Other objects means what? Request comma response objects, guys. Fine. This diagram we already seen, but today what is extra? Thread is extra. Okay. Now tell me how to prove three sets of request comma response objects are created. Very simple. Give three requests from three browser windows, three browser tabs, because everything should be treated as a client. Come on. Okay. Check it out. So three requests from this one. Okay, then try to print request comma response object hash codes in every request. Or if for every request, if it is creating a new request object, existing request object should be unrefreshed. Okay, dereferenced. And at least it should be in a position to whether we paid that those things or not. So by checking whether request object is created or not, we can say these request and response objects are created or not. But how to check whether request object is created or not? By printing hash codes. By printing hash codes of the objects, we can feel whether object is created or not. Now tell me, boss, I have to prove that all requests coming to servlet component will use single object of servlet component. What is the benefit in that?
How to prove that? You try to print hash code of this object, guys. Hash code of threads, hash code of request, comma, response objects. Come on. Okay. This hash code of servlet will remain fixed for all the requests. This request, comma, response object hash codes will change time to time. Come on. And this threads related hash code also will change time to time. So this is to prove that our servlet component is what? Single instance multiple threads component. What is that? Single instance multiple threads component. This proves that our servlet component is single instance multiple threads component. Multiple threads component. Multiple because the servlet container creates multiple threads and multiple sets of request, comma, response objects. Multiple sets of request, comma, response objects for multiple requests. For multiple requests, and all these threads will act on single object of our servlet component class. Will act on single object of our servlet component class. Come on, guys. If we give 10 requests to servlet component, 10 sets of request, comma, response object, 10 threads processing 10 requests. Only one object will be created for our servlet component class. I hope you got a clarity, guys. Come on. Right. But I have to prove this one practically, guys. I need to prove this one practically. Yes. Okay. Tomorrow when we meet, I will prove it practically. So I'll print the hash codes. Sir, tell me how to print the hash code of any object, guys. Object dot hash code method is there or not there? Okay. Yeah, thread is also object internally. We can print hash code. Request and response are object. We can print hash code. Our servlet class object is also object. We can print hash code. Array threads are objects internally, right? So by getting current thread and if you print the hash code of it, you'll be knowing whether they are using what? Same browser, different browser. All this stuff will come out of it. I hope you got a clarity. Okay. In Java, every object is uniquely identified. Object is having unique identity value. Unique identity value called hash code. We can print this hash code by calling hash code method of java.lang.object class. Hash code method of java.lang.object class. Okay, guys. Yeah, if any method is there in object class, it is there everywhere in Java or not, guys. Okay. Sir, what we learned in today's class? Today we learned improvisation of first application only. I mean, it's a servlet based application. when 404 error comes, what are the things you have to see? We have to see one of these conditions are matching. If matching, correct it. Don't overlook the condition. Do hurry, worry. 500 means some problems towards instantiationing and loading of our servlet component class. Maybe loading object, loading class, maybe creating object for construct issue. Whatever the issue, yes, 500 error will come. And remaining points we already discussed. What is this? Servlet container is not creating not creating object using your choice constructor. It always creates object by using zero param constructor. So we must place zero param constructor directly or what? Indirectly. Understanding my statement, guys? Come on. Right. All these are the fundamentals. Okay. Tomorrow I will prove that servlet component is single instance multiple threads component by demonstrating this diagram part practically.